thirsty. Bring it over. Chicken thigh, thigh, thigh. The bananas is thirsty. Baby, bring it over here. The birthday. Baby, bring it over here for some birthday. Baby, bring it over. Shut it in the birthday. Then bring it over here. Nah.
So the sun is out because in this little video, I'm going to be reviewing the cycling sunglasses I'm wearing on my face right now called the SunGuard Pace Breakers. Now, for clarity, this video is not sponsored. I'm not getting paid to do it. However, about 8 months ago, David from SunGuard, he's their head of marketing out of the UK, reached out to me over at Bike Chaser. It's an online marketplace I run for cycling products, asking me if I'd do a review on the SunGuard Pace Breakers. And I said yes. I wrote a review and they ended up becoming my Criterium glasses, and I've worn them ever since over the other cycling sunglasses I wear. As a result, I've had a few people reach out, well, not a few, quite a lot actually, asking me about the sunglasses, so I thought I would do a review. Now, I've indicated to SunGuard that I would be doing a review. They've sent me over a link, which is an affiliate link, so if you choose to purchase through that link, I do get a slight commission. However, I've also negotiated with David at SunGuard that we have a 10% discount to my YouTube supporters, but that, according to SunGuard policy, that link can only last for 48 hours. So if you're watching this video within the first 48 hours, you want to make a purchase, link will be below. So let's break this review into three parts. Now, I've just taken the SunGuards off because I like for you to be able to see my eyes while I'm talking to you. So the first thing, let's talk about what I like about them. There's two key factors there. Number two is I've got other cycling glasses that I used to use in my back pocket, the Oakley Radars and the Bollé B-Rock. So I want to do a bit of a comparison. And number three, let's talk about price, delivery, and overall experience. So the first thing, what I like about them. Number one is they're dickhead proof. Now, if you've been watching this channel for a while now, you'll probably know that I have some dickhead tendencies. And they include leaving things lying around, dropping things, stepping on things, etc. And the SunGuards, they've got a whole bunch of technical features which I'll put up on the screen, which make them very hard to damage. A couple of call outs that I'll make here is the frames are made of a material called memory polymer, I think that's how you say it, which are kind of anti-bend and flex resistant. And David at SunGuard has even said that they've had people drive over these things, and obviously the lens haven't lasted, but the actual frames have survived. So it's a very strong material, and it's meant that SunGuard have actually give a lifetime guarantee on their sunglasses, including accidental damage. So if you do leave them on the ground in the driveway or something, reverse over them and smash them to pieces, they'll replace them. It's pretty unbelievable. The second part is the lenses have, the outer surface of the lenses has three coatings to make them scratch resistance. Now, I've scratched mine, but if I compare these glasses to other glasses that I own, the scratches are minimal. So clearly, this three-layer coating system works. The second big thing I like about the SunGuards is their custom design. You build your own. Now, other brands do offer this, but it tends to be rather expensive. And this is part of the standard part of the SunGuard process, where you can pick your own frame, your own lenses, your own ear socks, and also the SunGuard logo on the side. Now, when I built mine, I built them with the Inform Make kit in mind, black and white. But if I was to do it again with the orange TM Insight on this kit, this is probably what I would go for. So I've put them back on because I'm going to do a little demonstration for you here, comparisons. So now I've got on the Oakley Radars. Now, we used to wear these back in the good old Inform racing days. A number of years ago now, and you might be able to see there's a few scratches on the lenses there, but I don't know about you, let me know below. They have a very similar look to the SunGuard Pace Breakers, and definitely a similar feel, the way they wrap around your face. I'm not too sure on the Oakley Radars what technology they have on their ear socks, but on the SunGuards is this hydrophilic material that as you sweat, it becomes grippier. And I've certainly noticed in some Glenvale A-grade Criterions when I was back in Melbourne, the more I sweated, the more they stuck to my face, which is what you want. You don't want them bouncing around on your face. Now, the main sort of call out in terms of the design that I've noticed is you've got 10 mil more length in the glasses, so it sort of covers more of your vision below and surrounding. But outside of that, they look pretty similar. So now I've got the Bolli B-Rocks on. Now, I wore these sunglasses when I rode the entire length of New Zealand over 13 days in the middle of winter in 2017. And I loved these then because they covered up more of my face. It was freezing cold in New Zealand. I was freezing my dick off most days. And just to have a little bit more extra coverage on the face was a good thing. Also, as I'm getting older, I've got the frown lines going. So to cover up, you know, your frown lines, to keep the wind and the air out of there while you're riding, I think is a good thing. So the Bollies get a couple of big ticks. They are a lot softer, like the materials on the Oakleys and the Sun Guides, the frame material is a lot harder. These sunglasses are softer, which makes them comfortable. But I do notice, like, when I move my head around, start sweating, they do sort of tip forward on my face a bit, and I'm pushing them back onto my nose a bit. So that is a little bit frustrating. And I think in terms of general design, I prefer the smaller sunglasses of the Oakleys or the Sun Guides over these. I don't know about you, you can let me know below. So just rolling home now along the beautiful Noosa River on my left-hand side here. And just to wrap up that last part, I think all three cycling sunglasses are really well made cycling glasses. If you want more technical specifications on the other two, I'll provide links below. But I think the Sun Guides have a competitive advantage, and yes, it's a specific shape, but you've got a lot of flexibility around the color, the design, etc. So to wrap up on price, you're probably going to hit 155 AUD. You can get them a little bit cheaper depending on what you put on them, but you'll probably land 155 AUD. I'll put the other prices in other currencies up on the screen. Now that's a big competitive advantage over the other two, because you're probably going to land anywhere between 200 to 300 for the other two, depending on where you shop. And I think it can be done through Sun Guide and have the same quality because they're direct to consumer, similar to like the Canyon model. But the other thing I really enjoyed about the experience was it says 3-day shipping on the website, but I got mine in 2. And also just dealing with David and the team at Sun Guide, it's been a really pleasurable experience. In fact, I've recently handed them over to Inform Make, because the Inform team, Insight Make cycling team, may be wearing the Sun Guides next season. So, great brand, great people, great pair of cycling sunglasses. If you're on the market, I'll provide a link below, and I hope to catch you all in the next video.